settle down.
Needs to settle down as well. So those are the surprises for me in terms of those.
Babatunde Michael is injured.
Of course.
Michael Uchebo.
Maybe
the fallout of the World Cup.
The fallout of the World Cup.
People that felt that it wasn't
exactly
measuring up.
Yeah, it wasn't up to scratch.
Shall I be the same thing?
Yeah, shall I be too? I think. I think he's done.
And he's gone to Turkey.
He's done what he set out to do. He wanted to appear for Nigeria at the major tournament. He's done that. We should just put him out to pasture and let him retire gracefully. But in terms of those who are called up, interesting names: Omar Sani Aluko. I believe this is one player who has never been really given a fair chance at the Super Eagles. So that for me is one of the standout names. Osagodo Igodaro doing very well on the domestic scene. Bola Osalami, we know how talented he is, but he's like Nigeria's version
Mario.
Of Mario Balotelli.
No, it says it's not Mario Balotelli. Bola Osalami
and Luis Suarez rolled into one. But there's no denying
the skills and the ability and the potential.
And I think probably the biggest that's probably the biggest disappointment for a lot of people. How talented he has never really translated that to being the true star that he can be. But for me, the major question is this. Who drew up this list?
Yeah.
If that is one thing for you to have a team in place, it's another thing for you to have someone who's going to think at this team. Who drew up this list?
Yes.
Was it in conjunction with
Keshi?
Keshi, in quotes. Was it in conjunction with the backroom staff of Keshi? Who is going to handle this? Normally, in these kind of situations, you would have heard a proper FA announce an interim coach in case a substantial coach has not been announced. But we don't have an interim coach. We don't have a substantial coach. But we have a team.
So we have a coach in waiting.
We have a coach in waiting.
So we have three scenarios. Why didn't you put that scenario that there's a coach in waiting? Who has been communicating with the football house and has been negotiating on a new contract?
So that for me is particularly key. If it was Keshi who drew up this list, then I have no problems with this. If it is Keshi that is going to take charge of this team. But if it's not Keshi, it's going to be an interim coach, there will be issues. Because it's one thing for the FA to drop a list of players for you. It's another thing for the coach to say, these are the players that I can work with. And the truth is, these are crucial games. Congo at home will be very difficult. South Africa have always wanted to get one over Nigeria in a competitive game. For an FA and a team in disarray, have been African champions as well. There is no bigger scalp on the African continent than the Super Eagles. We have to get our house in order, otherwise there will be trouble.
My sources tell me
that
this list is Keshi's list.
Okay.
So does that solve any problem?
Yeah, your sources are always
My sources are always telling me.
Yeah.
My sources have told me that Keshi drew up this list.
Okay.
Does that solve every problem?
Second base.
No. That doesn't solve the problem because yes, they may have told him, please, we are working on a contract for you. We will sort things out. Can you give us the names of players that you will want for these double letters? But it doesn't mean that the deal has been concluded or Keshi has signed the contract.
Because the story is coming out
that the NFF want to keep him on the same amount of money it was when the first contract was running. Can that work? For me, I just want to advise the Nigerian Football Federation, put something new on the table. Add something to the former contract. Make it an improved contract from the first time. I don't want us to dwell too much. Let it be better than the first one. If it was getting 5 million, even if it is 0.5 that you're going to put on top of this new one, put something.
There have been instances in the past where players or managers have been given the same contract. But if all parties were happy about it, about the previous terms of the contract, it has happened that the contract has been extended on the same existing terms. But now the NFA have to look at it that has he performed creditably well in terms of their scorecard? Would they score him average or above average? Everything he has done over the past two years with the Eagles, does it merit him having an upgrade of his contract? Then there's also cash on his side. What is he asking for? Does he feel he deserves more than he's currently getting? Don't forget there are also issues that are not resolved. Accommodation.
Backroom staff.
We're never giving you.
Because somebody told us. Somebody told us.
I want to confirm it.
Is Keshi actually that pays for the assistant coach?
Exactly.
Yeah.
He's
Keshi that pays from his own.
It's unheard of.
So these are issues that we need to resolve. These are supposed to be the improvement to the contract.
Exactly. There are also issues there. We've talked about the proper backroom staff for a modern football outfit? Does he have video analysts?
He does.
Does he have nutrition specialists?
Does he have video assessors? Whether they are effective or not is a different issue. It's got all those things. Mm. But just not to waste more time on this issue, I think improve the contract. It's either you begin to pay the bills of his assistants or you put something extra on the table for Keshi. That Make is. It an improved offer. That's what I feel. It should be an improved offer for Keshi. Yep. Really. And I hope that Alhaji Aminu Megere, in the spirit of reconciliation that's currently going on, will also look at this and do it so that everybody can be smiling. But let's move away from the football. Now, we've talked about the football, and I think we've exhausted the issue of the football.
Let's go to the politics.
Let's just quickly talk about the politics, very quickly. Like the communique of the Nigeria Football Federation Executive Committee, they've had like 8 meetings in the last 4 weeks.
More than they've had in the past.
In fact, more than they've had in the last 2 years. It's a meeting. And if it's going to move Nigerian football forward, what can we say? But let me just read through for you. This is very key. The first one is very key. The executive committee said they are proposing a new roadmap leading to elections into the NFF executive committee for consideration and approval by the General Assembly at the Congress slated for Warri Delta State on August 26, 2014. What that means is that elections will not take place anymore on August 26. What will be happening on the 26th of August is the NFF proposing to the Congress, look, FIFA says, let us go and draw up a new roadmap leading to fresh elections that will be inclusive, open, fair, and free. And they will propose it, and the Congress will modify, agree or disagree,
ratify.
And then they will fix a date, usually not more than a week after, for the elections to go on. The last elections we had in 2010, remember, it was also moved by a week. So that's what they are proposing. So elections will no longer take place on the 26th of August from the body of that letter. Mm-hmm. That's the first one.
Okay.
Taiwo Punjabi, Dapolamadeshino, Chikilo Eloyansi, Arisin Jala, unbanned, no conditions attached. The other guys said, unless Okunjobi withdraws his case from CAS. But this Aminu Megere-led guys have come and said, look, unbanned in the spirit of fair play. Everybody unbanned.
And reconciliation.
Unbanned. So Okunjobi can get back as Osun FA chairman, back as a member of the Congress to contest or to be contested against. That for me is also good news in a bit to reconcile the football family. The boards of the leagues, that's the Nigerian National League, the Nigerian Women League, the Nigerian Nationwide League, have 2 more years to go before their elections. They came into office January 2012.
Yeah.
And so they should stay till 2016.
Of course.
16.
As stipulated by the guidelines.
Yeah. And that's in line with the oath that they took. They are supposed to be in office for four years. And then the NFF Secretariat, and to enable adequate arrangements are made, preparations for the Eagles 2014 AFCON qualifiers at home to Congo Brazzaville on September 6 or 7, I don't know which date now, in Calabar, and then away to South Africa on the 10th of September. So those are the issues, the other issues apart from the football.
Mm.
All right. But Tunde, very quickly, elections are not likely to take place anymore on the 26th of August. They could be moved by a week just for them to be able to satisfy FIFA's condition that you throw it open and make it all inclusive.
Tony, that, as far as I'm concerned, is probably the most important condition in the communique. It was a masterstroke because if they persisted and said on the 26th they are going to hold elections,
with the way things are right now,
it would have been disastrous. I don't know what. There would have been physical warfare.
I wouldn't have gone to cover
this. No, absolutely not.
Because the court case this time, they say even those who witnessed it and those who covered it will go to.
Are you afraid of court case? I'm saying there'll possibly be physical confrontation.
Yeah, exactly. I think it's a smart one.
Exactly. Very smart. How tense everything was back then. So I think it was a wise masterstroke on the part of the Aminu Megere-led board. Now they're going to throw it open. All those who have been banned, who had issues regarding their names.
Let me list out their names.
I was in Scotland when I watched the show. I said, when some people came, they asked for form.
There were no forms.
Other people came to ask for the same form.
They got the forms. You know. Anyway, maybe we'll leave this till tomorrow.
Oh, we should.
The name of the aide to the sports minister that has been mentioned frequently, has allegedly been involved. The name keeps popping up. That is the one behind all that happened, all the shenanigans that happened leading to the Forms not being available. The name of this particular aid to the sports minister keeps coming up. Let's leave it till tomorrow and see how things.
I think we should clear this.
Very, very clear.
So
let me mention the names of some of those who. Abayola wanted to get forms, couldn't get. Amanzi Chebulam
wanted to.
No way. Odegbami was able to get form somehow.